everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you get to take your trig and inverse trig knowledge to the next level by applying these skills to real-world situations involving an angle of elevation or depression. Let's see what all this is about. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to solve for an unknown value in a scenario involving an angle of elevation or depression. First, we'll discuss what angle of elevation or depression means, and then we'll learn how to set up an equation from a scenario. Let's say that this is Devin. Devin is a few stories up on a building, and instead of looking straight out into the distance, he looks slightly down to see his friend Elliot. This horizontal line and Devin's line of sight create an angle called the angle of depression. Now let's talk a little more about Elliot. If Elliot were looking straight out in front of him, he would be looking at the side of the building. But instead, he's looking up at Devin. These two lines create an angle too. What do you think this angle is called? Yep, this one is the angle of elevation. Now let's say goodbye to Devin and Elliot so that we can take a little closer look at what we created here. If we just focus on these segments and the transversal between them, what can you tell me about the relationship between the angle of depression to the angle of elevation? We determined earlier that we have two horizontal lines, and since they have the same slope, they're parallel to each other. And with this line of sight acting as the transversal, what kind of angle pair are the angles of elevation and depression? Are they consecutive interior angles, corresponding angles, alternate interior angles? Yep, they're alternate interior angles. So due to the alternate interior angle theorem, they are congruent. You may be wondering how this relates to our trig unit, since there's been no mention of right triangles so far. Well, all we have to do to make a right triangle is add in a vertical segment here. This would now be a right triangle because there's a vertical and horizontal line meeting to form a right angle. And here's another right triangle. Since these triangles are congruent to each other, it's up to you which right triangle you'll choose to work with. For most scenarios, like our Devin and Elliot scenario, it will probably just seem more logical to use this triangle so that it's easier to visualize that the sides represent the height along the building and the distance between Elliot and the building. As you learned in your solving triangles lesson, if you have a right triangle, you just need two other known values within your triangle to be able to solve for any unknown. For example, let's try this problem. This says the angle of depression from a 45-meter lighthouse to a boat is 22 degrees. How far away from the base of the lighthouse is the boat? The first step in solving a problem like this is to sketch a picture. The goal is to create a triangle that includes the two given measurements and an unknown to solve for. It also may help to sketch in a boat and a lighthouse, but that's not required. Pause the video and think this through. See if you can create a sketch similar to the Devin and Elliot sketch that we looked at earlier. Do you have a rough sketch of a lighthouse and boat? Nothing super fancy is needed here. Yours definitely doesn't need to look like mine. Just draw whatever you need to help you visualize the situation. The important part is creating the triangle that relates these to each other so that we can solve. Did you fill in the given information and place your unknown? Here's my sketch of the angle of depression. Here's the height of the lighthouse. And I chose to use x as the variable and labeled the distance between the lighthouse and the boat as the unknown value. And all these things come together, we have this. We could see the 22 degree angle of depression. Isn't it in a super useful place? Because it's not inside the triangle. But do you remember what we learned a few moments ago about the angle of elevation and the angle of depression? They're congruent, so we can copy this 22 degree angle down here into the triangle. Then, if it helps, we can get rid of some of the extra details that we don't need anymore and just focus on the triangle we created. If you prefer your side labels to be outside of the triangle, that is fine too. Now, how would we solve this? You've learned how to solve for missing side lengths a few lessons back. And we also know that since we're solving for a side length, we're going to be using regular trig, not inverse trig. Go ahead and set up an equation and solve for the unknown. Pause the video and do it now. Here's the work and the solution rounded to the tenths place. Oh, and also, once you've solved for the unknown here, be sure to go back and label what your solution means. In this case, it's the number of meters between the boat and the base of the lighthouse. So our final answer is 111.4 meters. Now it's your turn to practice making your own triangles from scenarios, and then using what you already know about trig and inverse trig to solve for an unknown. Also, be sure to check with an adult and the key to make sure you finished solving the problem from a moment ago correctly, and finish up your notes template before starting the practice game. See you next time!